We came in as men and we walked out as gentlemen after that. It's a very proud feeling to don the uniform. एक बहुत ही respectful बात है इस बारे में.
I was asking a casting director recently this, that why, you know, because they were offering me something in a uniform. So I said, why am I being offered stuff in a uniform? So it's a personality thing. It goes very well with the uniform. I will gladly do it many, many times because I think it's an absolute honor and a privilege.
I think as normal civilians, हम काफी desensitized हो जाते हैं क्योंकि news में अमूमन खबरें आती हैं कि सो एंड सो जगह में ये हो गया, सो एंड सो जगह में वो हो गया. तो वी लूज कंपैशन, वी लूज सेंसिटिविटी, वी लूज इंटरेस्ट. जब आप एक ऐसी फिल्म करते हैं, जब आप एक ऐसे माहौल में इतने दिन बिताते हैं, तो यू आर कॉन्स्टेंटली रिमाइंडेड के देर आर पीपल हु आर पेइंग अ प्राइस फॉर द काइंड ऑफ लाइफ वी आर लिविंग, विच इज अ प्रिविलेज.
So I'd like to start by saying a thank you for breathing life into Shershaah's world. This was a story really relevant and needed to be known. So Nikitin, Shiv and Shataf sir, thank you for taking out time for this and we are so happy to have you joining with us today.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I want to know from each of you, being a part of a war film and especially a patriotic film, what has been your biggest takeaway? Starting with Shiv.
I think a lot of respect, a lot of gratitude for our armed forces. Mm-hmm. I mean, I was always very respectful of them and was very grateful, you know, for them giving me the comfortable life that I live.
Yeah.
But I think reminders like this, like a film like Shershaah or being part of an experience like Shershaah, I think are very important for every civilian to go through from time to time because, you know, we are human beings. We end up taking things for granted. We end up living our life and we end up getting caught up in the trivialities of our daily lives. And it is films like these and reminders like this, which is very important for civilians to get from time to time, is in my opinion.
As I have mentioned earlier as well, we came in as men and we walked out as gentlemen after that. Yeah. It's a very proud feeling. It's a very proud feeling, one, to don the uniform. Mm-hmm. Ek bahut hi respectful baat hai is bare mein. So there are loads of takeaways. Yeah, one is to understand that just Shiv ne kaha abhi ki hum apne comforts mein baithe rehte hain aur wahan pe actually kya hota hai, what the soldiers go through, you know, the Indian army, what kind of challenges they face to make sure that we are safe. So all of that, when you experience it in such close quarters, na,
yeah,
wo respect alag level pe chal gaya. We are very patriotic, of course. We've always respected our army, our Indian army, all our forces.
Yes.
But once you live these moments like Shershaah's shoot, you actually get to understand the pain, the struggle, the sacrifice, the grit, the courage that they have displayed. So for us, it was, you know, we always hear about it. But kyunki jab hum shoot kar rahe the, hamare paas, you know, a lot of people in the unit were also from the army. So unke saath rehna, unke saath kuch unki baatein sunna, unse kuch seekhna, ये सब पूरा अपना जो नजरिया है वो बदल देता है और अच्छे के लिए. सो यू नो वी जस्ट फॉर्चूनेट वी ब्लेस्ड कि हमें ये अपॉर्चुनिटी मिला एंड टेक अवे बहुत है बहुत है बहुत.
आई थिंक शिव एंड शताफ हैव समड इट अप प्रीटी वेल. जो ये ऐसा एक्सपीरियंस है बहुत कम एक्टर्स को मिलता है एट दिस क्लोज क्वार्टर्स. जैसे शताफ ने कहा कि हमारी यूनिट में एक्चुअल आर्मी मैन थे, हमारी हमारे साथ रोज उनका उठना बैठना था. तो आई थिंक एज नॉर्मल सिविलियंस हम काफी डिसेंसिटाइज हो जाते हैं क्योंकि न्यूज में अमूमन खबरें आती हैं कि सो एंड सो जगह में ये हो गया, सो एंड सो जगह में वो हो गया. तो वी लूज कंपैशन, वी लूज सेंसिटिविटी, वी लूज इंटरेस्ट वेरी फास्ट. हम चैनल बदल देते हैं क्योंकि हमें क्या फर्क पड़ा है, हम तो यहाँ बैठे हैं. लेकिन जब आप एक ऐसी फिल्म करते हैं, जब आप एक ऐसे माहौल में इतने दिन बिताते हैं, तो यू आर कॉन्स्टेंटली रिमाइंडेड के देर आर पीपल हु आर पेइंग अ प्राइस फॉर द काइंड ऑफ लाइफ वी आर लिविंग, विच इज अ प्रिविलेज. तो आई थिंक द अटेम्प्ट थ्रू दिस फिल्म में शायद जो हमारे यू नो देशवासी हैं उनको भी एक ग्लिम्स मिले इनटू अ लाइफ कि ये भी एक नॉर्मल विक्रम बत्रा भी जो एक नॉर्मल इंडियन आदमी था, इंडियन आदमी थे चंडीगढ़ से, जो जिन्होंने आर्मी ज्वाइन किया और फिर वहां पर उनके साथ जो एक जर्नी हुई और क्या हुआ, So I think it is just help people identify a little more with your armed forces.
Yeah.
Even they are as, you know, vulnerable as us and as human as us.
True.
And we should just have this respect for them irrespective. So I think all these things are an amalgamation jo hua hai people karne ke darmiyan.
So, you know, making a biopic also comes with certain responsibilities. Every time you have to make sure that your characters don't look caricatured, right? So, as actors, were there challenges that you had to overcome individually?
So, basically, all our characters are from different parts of India who joined this particular regiment in the army. Mm-hmm. And sabka ek alag lehja hota hai, ek alag tarika hota hai baat karne ka, very specific. But we wanted a more universal appeal, we stuck to normal, you know, Hindi. Because of this reason, because we didn't want them to become caricatures. We didn't want to look like mimics. We didn't want to sound like we are people aping these brave hearts. Mm-hmm. So we played it in our own way, but being very mindful about the kind of characters that we are playing. Ki ye aadmi kaun the, ye wo jazba rakhte hue, lekin we brought a lot of ourselves. Like perhaps the way Shataf speaks is not how Colonel Joe speaks, but that's Shataf playing if Shataf was Colonel Joe. Question is that the emotion is the same, but we brought a little of ourselves into it so that the people can see the story without getting, diverted with the gimmicks of everything else.
True.
Didn't want it to look gimmicky, basically.
It's a huge responsibility when you are playing, you know, legends like these, honorable men. So you have to be very particular and it becomes very challenging. But I believe that we were such a wonderful team, such mature, seasoned actors that we really wanted to keep it as honest as possible. Yahan pe honesty ki badi baat hai that, you know, you portray your characters honestly. Hamari yahi koshish thi, Vishnu sir ka saath tha, bharosa tha un pe. The memories, the wonderful times that we had, वो तो है ही है, but हाँ, responsible बहुत होना पड़ता है क्योंकि you know you don't want to portray what is not or what was not. So challenges, but most amazing challenges.
I think if you try to ape somebody on screen and somewhere, somehow, there'll always be a slight dissimilarity between your performance and who that person is in real life. Yes. So that was something which our director, Mr. Vishnu Vardhan, was very clear from day one. He said, I am not interested in you guys becoming mimics or, you know, copying their mannerisms in any way. Mm-hmm. I wanted to understand the essence of who you're playing.
Yeah.
The mental trauma, predicament, the mental toughness which they had to face when they were on a height of 12,000, 14,000 feet and they were, you know, fighting the Pakistani army at that point. What was their mental psyche at that point?
Yeah.
So essentially understand the person's soul, if you can, or understand the person's for that period of that war. What was the essence of your character? And then in your own way, try and bring that essence alive. So, you know, like Nikitin very correctly has said, ki I think the idea object here is not to impersonate anyone, but it is to bring your own interpretation
this thing
alive. Yeah. You know, your own interpretation of a legend or hero like Colonel YK Joshi, now he's Brigadier YK Joshi. And Colonel Sanjeev Singh Jamwal. So, you know, it is that endeavor to try and bring that alive.
So, you know, Shiv, if I rewind a little, one can say that you have played a range of uniformed officers earlier. So, do you feel you often get typecast or repetitive roles that way?
I think it's a... I don't know which other uniformed officers that I've played.
I have seen you in sub.
Yeah, so I've done one... I've done one television comedy show in my career, and I was a police inspector.
Yeah.
You know, it's very interesting you asked me this question because, you know, I was asking a casting director recently this, that why, because they were offering me something in a uniform. So I said, why am I being offered stuff in a uniform? Mm-hmm. So I said, they said, sir, it's, Nick, don't laugh. They said, sir, it's a personality thing. It goes very well with the uniform. Mm-hmm. Then that, yeah, anyway. No, so actually, the thing is that I have not played too many uniformed officers. This is my second outing. This is my first outing as a as an Indian Army officer. Mm-hmm. I have played a police officer before. Mm-hmm. But I can tell you one thing, that I will gladly do it many, many times, because I think it's an absolute honor and a privilege to be able to play, to play an officer, an armed officer or a police officer. Because, mm-hmm. I mean, sure, depending on the context of what you're doing, I just think it's a great responsibility, because, you know, when you portray these characters well, and when you actually meet the real life policemen or the army officers, you get a sense of pride, because they look at you as they say, boyo, really good job, man. You really went and, you did a great shot. Or you did a great thing. Yeah. You really made us come alive, man. You really got our stories out to the forefront. And it's a sense of pride, you know, when you hear that.
True. So, you know, Shataf sir, coming to you, for someone who has explored independent and world cinema, you know your character's viewpoint matters the most in such films. Since Shershaah is out and out dwelling in Vikram's worldview, was it challenging, you know, to have a balance in finding your character's worldview as well as focus on Shershaah's? As an actor, what were your priorities?
Well, as an actor, my first priority, I always believed in one thing, is the script and the director.
Yeah.
And when you work with a director like Vishnu and have an amazing team and amazing co-actors, you know, you don't need to search too hard for the balance. They create the balance for you. True. So that's what happened with Shershaah with me, was that, yes, of course, you'd have your preparation, you do your homework and blah, blah, blah. Mm-hmm. But these worlds are so well created. Like Sandeep sir, who has written the script, he has created these worlds so easily, so beautifully, that, you know what, to be honest with you, that becomes easy.
Okay.
What becomes challenging is just going there and delivering what you're supposed to do.
Mm-hmm.
So that's, I think, you know, it was not very difficult to find a balance in this. Yes, the priorities were right. The guidance was right. The vision was right. So what happens is that your actor's life becomes very, very easy to perform under such circumstances.
That's nice. That's right as well. So, Nikitin, despite doing a lot of action films, it does feel you are pretty selective about scripts. What made you choose Shershaah?
Actually, I was looking for, something where I can get to play a positive role.
Okay.
Because I try to be to do characters where I'm not repeating myself.
Mm-hmm.
So if it's a Thangavali, I'll make sure I don't do the similar space again and again.
Mm-hmm.
And by God's grace, I keep getting roles which are different from each other. So when this came my way, firstly, it was a positive role. Secondly, it was at the honor of playing an army officer. Thirdly, it was a real life person. Fourthly, it was being made by a production house as prestigious as Dharma and Kash Entertainment, and it has Vishnu Vardhan at the helm of it. So I think there were so many points that were just fantastic for me, and it just was like everything I could ask for to start my journey in the realm of positive roles.
Mm-hmm.
And also the kind of bravado this character had that I'm portraying. So it really was fantastic, to be very honest.
Okay. So, you know, my last question was, there's a typical stereotype attached to the portrayal of uniformed officers in Bollywood cinema. Like, you know, you're supposed to look, talk, breathe and walk a certain way. Since all of you play uniformed army officers here, what was that one thing which you feel will make your characters stand out, given the fact that it's a biopic and it already follows a different storyline?
I think our story is more than any of the outlines, like you mentioned, the body language and the words. I think it's more about the human relationships and the relationships Captain Vikram Batra had with these men in his lifetime. And these men amongst themselves that they had. So I think our film is more about the human relationship along with the everything else. So I think when the film starts, after a while, you'll forget about all these smaller details. Ki haath kaise rakha hai, kaise chal raha hai, kya kar raha hai. Because our focus is more on the war and these interpersonal relationships. So I think we have been very honest towards that portion and that aspect of the army, where people have a, where their guard is also down, where their human aspect is also there. एक सिंगुलर एस्पेक्ट दिखाया जाता है ऐसा नहीं है वी हैव शोन डिफरेंट एस्पेक्ट्स इन दिस
So, yeah, and if you end up focusing on what you said, those typical tropes which are there, then I think we have lost as a unit. I think what Nikitin is saying, it makes a lot of sense, is that if we are able to bring you into the world and absorb you into the world of Shershaah, Captain Vikram Batra, his life, you know, from college to the army and the people he's met along his journey, if we're able to engulf you in that world, then that's a victory for us as a unit. But if we're not able to do that, then I guess we've actually lost. And then I guess you focus on the cliches, if you will, you know, the typical, the points which you mentioned.
Yeah, true. So I really look forward to, you know, look at the emotional aspect, because when I watched the trailer, I realized that the film is focusing more on the personal relationships and especially Vikram Batra's emotional worldview or his point of view towards serving his country or be his interpersonal relationships.
Right.
So thank you so much for taking out time for this and doing this with me. I had a great time conversing with you. All the best for Shershaah, and I'm sure it will hit the right audience the right way.
Thank you,
ma'am. Thank you
so much for your wishes. So sweet.